All right, this is actually going to be a fun one for me. You might think that coral dips, like, what are they? Who cares? But you know what? There's actually some really cool stuff. So best of 2019, coral dips. We're going to share this all with you, starting with most popular and then...
Yeah, most popular, the general pests. So kind of like your, once over type deal. But then there's some specific ones, like best for euphilia, LPS, and softies. Best for algae. Probably a DIY for SPS.
Mm-hmm.
And then we'll wrap it up with
best in show, and then what we'd like to see for 2020. All right, so most popular in 2019, as voted by you guys, and what you guys are picking up, which one is it?
Boom. Coral RLX, yeah, I mean, this one has been around for quite a while, and we used it in a couple videos where we gave you our whole, dipping procedure, and it's one of those, natural type ones, probably like tea tree oil or something like that, and a few other things.
Yeah, so there's like a lot of them have like pine oil and whatnot. So this is the number one, as voted by you guys, most popular of 2019. All right, so best of 2019 for general pest. I mean, what does general pest mean before we hit it?
Yeah, I think everybody should have some kind of coral dip in their cabinet or what have you, and at least dip everything. So if you're not gonna get into all the different types of dips and specific ones, there should be one for general pests. And these are that, nudibranch type pests, or maybe flat some worms. Regular flatworm type pests, things
fire
like
worms,
that.
Fireworms, bristleworms.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, all kinds of copepods and stuff like that fall off. So just general one. Really, it's kind of like a three-way tie. You're going to pick up any one of these things. They're all really about the same thing. Mm-hmm. So Coral RX, the Coral MD from Brightwell, and the Coral Revive from Two Little Fishes, all very, very similar products.
Yeah.
All of them you open up, instantly smells like Pine Sol.
Yeah.
It's those types of oils. Irritates those pests. Some of it just straight up kills them. A lot of times it just causes them to fall off, especially if you're switching it. They'll crawl out of the little crevices, and you can literally see on the bottom like everything that came out of it. Also, super, super safe.
Yeah.
Right? Like, you're not really going to kill anything of this. You can do it without a lot of concern about, hurting any coral. Just a generic, easy dip. That's probably why they're the most popular. By the way, this was the most popular one out there, and right behind it was actually Revive. So, the two most popular, that's why it's in that general group of coral dips. So, most popular, or actually the best, if you're just going to use it, use any one of these three. We should probably actually maybe next year do like a cost analysis, because some of them are more concentrated than others. And so if they're all kind of the same, get the cheapest one. All right, so now we're moving on to like using the right tool for the right job, and best coral dip for euphilia, for green star polyps, for softies, zoanthids, which are super popular to dip. What is it?
Yeah, some of the brown algaes and infections and things like that. These are iodine-based dips, and the two most popular on our site is the Tropic Marin Pearl Coral and the Brightwell Medicoral. So impossible to say which one works better than the other, because I just don't think you can have a viable test for that. But when it comes to, value-wise, this one's way cheaper, because it makes it's like 60 gallons of based on their concentration versus like 10 gallons based on their concentration. So I can get a lot more use out of that one.
This one costs like $3 more, I think, or something like that. But again, you make like five times as much. Mm-hmm. So I can't definitively tell you like one of these is better than the other, but I'm gonna buy based on cost. So best one for the year, I'm just gonna go with the Coral, or MediCoral from Brightwell is the best option. Again, in this case, what we're doing is trying to fight infections and stuff. Mm-hmm. And you can see all kinds of videos out there on YouTube where people take like, zoanthids that are totally closed up, right? And you dip them and all of a sudden tomorrow they're open. Green star polyps that mysteriously won't open, same thing, right? And that like brown bacterial slime that infects a lot of euphilia,
yeah.
Totally solved that as well. It's like an antiseptic type of dip. And I will tell you that I used it a lot on zoanthids combined with freshwater dips to get nudies and stuff off of them. And so they'll just like jettison, jump right off, right? And you'll see them floating around the bottom. So for that type of coral, best of the 2019 is the MediCoral from Brightwell. Okay, so again, right tool for the right job, best of 2019 for fighting or eliminating algae from your flag plugs and not adding all that to your system. Which one is it?
Yeah, this is direct advice from WWC. We got Josh on the phone here, and I've seen it used around the office and everything too, and it's hydrogen peroxide. So go to your local, you know, grocery store, pharmacy, what have you, grab some peroxide. Now, there are some caveats to that. Like, WWC uses it on zoas, where they will fully immerse like zoas in a solution, but no more than like 5 minutes, because they can handle it. But some other corals and a lot of LPS and SPS, Josh said, was like a little more sensitive to hydrogen peroxide, where they won't even dip it in the solution for any amount of time. Rather, take the frag plug, or that, you know, if you got a big LPS with a solid skeletal base and there's some algae on it, you can kind of dip it in there and brush it off, or just take a toothbrush, dip it in the hydrogen peroxide, scrub the frag plug off. But it's that hydrogen peroxide that does kill the algae.
So this is a big deal, because you can get alva, you can get bryopsis, you can get all kinds of really nasty algaes, like they come out of like all kinds of weird ones. And like they come on the base of your LPS, they come like riddled within the rock of your zoanthid colony, like, and you just don't want to add that to your tank, right? Yeah. You can see it growing on the frag plug, right? And so hydrogen peroxide works super, super well on that. And so one of the things that you've seen is make sure like to like kind of swish the coral. If you're going to dip the whole coral in it, which is, you can try it by like, you know, diluting it even, going from like 5 to 1 to, you know, or, you know, 20% solution to water. But in that case, you just want to swish it, make sure that all the zoanthids like close up first and they're protecting themselves, and then dip it, you know, for a pretty short period of time, a matter of minutes. And it will like actually kill all of the algae that's on there, and then you won't be adding that to your tank. You can, like he said, also, you know, take really fine touches to it. Grab a paintbrush and like literally paint it onto the algae around the frag plug. You could dip just the frag plug in there and not hit the actual coral. You could use a toothbrush with some of on there. But this case, you're gonna get all that off there, like especially on your like euphilia, like the skeletal structure that has all kinds of stuff on it a lot of time. Take a little bit of that stuff. You can dip the whole thing in there, or you can just kind of scrub it off with some of this. Works super well. We've actually used it in tanks where they had like total plague algae outbreak.
Oh yeah.
And you can just take something like this and literally spray it right on the rock.
Yeah,
you
know? The clownfish harem tank. Chad would drain it down to like 25%. And then spray the algae directly with hydrogen peroxide, let it sit, fill it back up like a water change. It doesn't pollute the water, it oxidizes itself out, right? And then you're good to go. And it did take care of the algae problem in that tank.
Yeah, I mean, it won't get down to the roots, it may come back in that case, but like on your frag plugs, it usually works super, super, super well. So for algae, you know, using the right tool for the right job, most of these will not kill algae, this guy will. I continue on that line of right tool for the right job. Best DIY coral dip for SPS, what is it?
Yeah, this is one I've used personally because I've had acro eating flatworms and nearly wipe out my system, fragged everything, put them in the tank, bare complete insecticide killer. It's all over the forums. Many of you guys seen it out there, and this is one that you just don't take lightly. If you're going to use it, you don't take it lightly. Safety is the number one key here.
Yeah, so like all those insecticides have all kinds of like health issues and stuff with them. So like, you know, you don't want to put your hands in the solution. You're going to wear like arm gloves, you know, and like not get it on your skin. Who knows what it's going to do to you, but it's not good. So like read the like instructions on the back of it and make sure to not like breathe it or get it on you or whatnot. But it kills acro eating flatworms for sure.
It did for me. And even Josh said like a while back that he used to use them all the time. Maybe at home he probably uses it too if he was going to. But it did actually work. It worked for me. Like so eggs and everything.
They explicitly said that it just doesn't work in a work environment. Like, but you can make your own risks at home. I don't know. I actually probably would, unless I really needed to. But I'll say for acro eating flatworms, like you can get a lot of things to get them to fall off. Right? So just clipping it off of the base at that point, making sure you don't get any of those eggs or anything, actually solves a lot of the problem right there without the dip. But if you want to do a DIY dip for that, it's super, super common. You can go out there and read about like the concentrations that people are making. You're not dipping it 100% strength or anything like that. Go find out. And the community kind of evolves every year and how they use it and how much they do. So go read about it. But it's the Bare Complete Insecticide. Really does a number on acro eating flatworms. All right, so best in show of 2019, which one of these is the best available coral dip out here?
Which one is my go? You know, it depends on what I'm treating, and so, of course, the right tool for the right job. I'm gonna use this in a specific case, I'm gonna use these in a specific case, I'm gonna use these in another specific case, not like one for everything.
Yeah, I agree 100%. So once you start to understand a coral dip isn't a coral dip isn't a coral dip, they're all used for a very specific purpose.
Yep.
I can use these on pretty much everything. Then when I have euphilia and I have zoanthids and whatnot, I can start to use these for a very specific purpose. If I got algae and I don't wanna add algae, I'm using it for a very specific purpose. So there isn't really a best in show of 2019 other than like really acknowledging that we use the right tool for the right job. All right, so what would we like to see for advancements in coral dips in 2020?
I mean, this is not a really technical area, but there are some improvements that we'd like to see. I'd like to see some better info on the bottles of what it does. So some of them have here on like removes, you know, mono-eating nudibranchs. So it has a list of things that it does. It doesn't have, you know, like which corals can it work on? Because we talked to Josh at WWC and he says some of these, they don't work on corals. He wouldn't put corals in certain types of corals in them, while others he would. So maybe some little research on that, on testing some corals. I mean, we can easily frag off a few pieces and try them out in different ones and see the results.
So absolutely. So I know a lot of the information always comes from the community and how they're doing it, but I'd like to see like all of these guys up their game a little bit. And some of these things, you know, maybe the concentration of this works okay, you know, for a chalice, or maybe it needs to be like a little lighter for that type of coral than, you know, a zoanthid, which is, you know, capable of protecting itself a little better. So, you know, I'd like better information on all these, what you can use it on, and maybe different strengths and stuff. And this is totally stuff that they could do on their own and, you know, do experiments and give better advice to all of us on how to use it. Mm-hmm. And I think in that, I'd also like to see like a dipping kit.
Yeah,
right?
if you line up a small sample of each one of these bottles, and like maybe half the size, but an iodine-based one of these, you know, tea tree or these natural type ones, maybe, and you'll probably get into this one next, but maybe peroxide in a bottle too, or, you know, just a kit that says, you know, you can dip your corals in all of these, here's the types of corals, and here's which ones to use them, but now I only have to buy one thing, and I can cover almost every coral that I want to bring in, so that would be awesome.
Then distinct advice on how to use it.
Yeah.
On zoanthid, you can do a two-step dip. Your acros, only one step, you know. Mm-hmm. And you can really find out how to use these things to like a better effect. So I'd love to see a little kit that tells you how to do this, gives you a little bit more advice. And then lastly, I'd actually like to see peroxide dip come out, right? I mean, that seems kind of crazy. You guys can just go out and buy one of these things and it's just fine,
yeah.
Right? However, when they start to make it, you know, two things will happen. One, more people will know that you can use peroxide as a dip and fight all of those algae in your tank. Because they'll literally probably say, you know, coral algae frag remover, you know, whatever on the front of it. And like, well, now I know what it does. It's not hydrogen peroxide topical solution USP, right? And then second, they can like start to play with it a little bit and say, you know what? This is the right strength for your zoanthids and acans and whatnot. But for, you know, SPS, you can still do it, but it's really, really low, or, you know, who knows? So like they can give you directions on, you know, in a way that, you know, this brown bottle is never gonna tell you, right?
Yeah.
So do it yourself community out there, man, like go buy this. I would probably buy this myself and, you know, just save some money. But at the same time, the existence of the retail one shares so much information with everybody out there that it's valuable to know that there is a dip out there for that. So I'd like to see somebody come out with something similar or a hydrogen peroxide based dip and be open about what it's inside of it and, you know, pay $2 extra, you know, for a picture of a coral in the front, I guess. I don't know, but let's expand the knowledge of how to use these things.
Mm-hmm.
And that's my goal. So if you want to see all of these coral dips, you can go over to our website and there's a little coral dip category. You can see what everybody thinks about each one of these, whether or not they agree with how we approach our approach or how we use it. So head on over to the site and check out our coral dips.